In this video, a circuit of an analog reverse motor switch. And here is the motor that this switch is driving. And the brand says, "We improve your life." Well, that's a very good advertisement. We improve your life. A 12-volt motor takes approximately 8 ampere, and I really don't know where it was made for, but anyway, the whole idea is to drive this motor via a relay, a 12-volt relay. That relay is here, of course, all experimental, but anyway, I will show the schematic. And let's first see what happens when we add 12 volt to the circuit, say 14 volts. And you can see here that the current to the motor is approximately 1 ampere or 1.5 ampere. That doesn't matter much. And the motor moves in two directions and approximately at the same time, and that's the first thing that I want to tell about this circuit. It's an analog circuit, and the way that the time is generated is by means of an electrolytic capacitor, or in fact two electrolytics. Here is a circuit. And you see here, in fact, a stable multivibrator circuit. And it's made with two BD139 transistors. Each transistor is coupled to the other one with an electrolytic capacitor. It's coupled from collector to base, and here from collector to base. And you can see we have here different values of electrolytics. That has everything to do with the timing. The circuit switches on and off on the basis of the base resistor here and on the electrolytic capacitor value here. And you can see here that I've used a 1 mega ohm, 1.5 mega ohm resistor to bridge the electrolytic capacitor, and that means that one of the time depending elements in this circuit can be changed to lose its charge more easily compared to the other one, and that's here. So here we can set a time, and also here there is a potentiometer that sets the bias of the second transistor, and that has also also an effect on the time. So the core of the circuit is here. And a stable multivibrator drives a classic Darlington circuit with a relay in the collector lead. And I've used by purpose this, say, quite high voltage transistor, the BU2708AF, because in practice I found that when I used here a BD139, that's a medium power silicon transistor, they constantly popped out, burnt out, within say 20 minutes or so. I don't know why that happened. Perhaps the EMF of the motor pushed back into the circuit, etc., etc., damaging the N transistor. But anyway, this worked good, and perhaps you can use a 3055 transistor. I'm almost sure that that also will work. There's a lot to tell about such a relay circuit, especially when we look at the contacts of the relays. They drive a motor, they drive this motor. In that motor there is a coil, and that means that when the motor is switched from one direction to the other direction, you will see sparks. I want to demonstrate it now. Have to put out all the lights, of course. Perhaps it's visible. It's not completely dark now. But say, when you do this experiment in the complete darkness, you will see that the motor relay, that the relay has a spark on its contacts, and I have by purpose used a few capacitors here that damp the sparks. So that's an issue. Here is the relay, the rest position. These connections are made, and in the activated position, the connections go to the other side here. That means that the voltage is reversed, and the motor moves in another direction. But at the same time, the electromagnetic force of the motor pushes a kind of energy out of the coil here into the circuit, and that makes that the relay sparks. So these are some primitive ideas to prevent sparks. And of course, in modern times, relays are not used. They use, for instance, MOSFETs or whatever, but this is a completely simple old school project anyway. So, not so much more to tell. The value of the capacitor set the time. Now it is 6 seconds in one direction and 6 seconds in another direction, reverse direction. You can set that here, the time, and you can set that here. I tried quite a few circuits. This was a first experiment, and made with a TL071 chip. It worked, but at the same time, it was sensitive to, say, voltages on the supply lead. I changed, for instance, one resistor here, and the whole circuit burned out. And it wasn't even a low-value resistor. So, anyway, this didn't work. I tested this circuit, and it worked. But it was quite a problem. To get the, say, motor move in one direction and in the other direction with, say, fixed value times. So you can also try this, but it doesn't work. And I found also that the BD140 popped out constantly, each 20 minutes it was defective. Even when I use this, say, diode that's often used to damp out the EMF on a relay coil, but anyway. And also here, the 27K that serves that same purpose to damp out voltage peaks, but anyway, it didn't work. And that's important. So, let's go back to the old school, very old school, a stable multivibrator that worked properly, could not be damaged by, say, all kinds of phenomenon, voltage sparks, peaks, etc. on the supply lead. So let's look again to the circuit. This is more or less the same time during which the motor moves in one direction and into the other direction. And that was always a problem in earlier circuits. And now it worked quite properly. But of course, with electrolytic capacitors, you always know that the capacitance changes somewhat during aging, during different, temperatures, and that's important. So there's no guarantee that this circuit will work on the same properties, the same times when you mount, for instance, this on a location where there is a very low temperature. Perhaps you have to change the capacitors in that way. Anyway, it's quite good. It works quite properly. And well, that was more or less all to tell. These potentiometers here, the 1M5 potentiometer, you can also use a 1 mega ohm potentiometer, does not change so much to the time. And also this one doesn't change so much to the time. They are more precise regulators. They set a time deviation within, say, seconds or so. So that's important. And when you want a real longer time or a shorter time, for a longer time, you must make this electrolytic bigger, give it a bigger value. And for a shorter time, give it a lower value. And also here. And when they are exactly the same, the time will also be the same, more or less, given the forward and the backward of the motor. But because there is here a 27K resistor and here a 10K resistor, I've done that by purpose, because otherwise it could be that the circuit doesn't want to start. There is some, say, deviation between the one transistor that's driving the circuit and the other one. So that also means that the capacitors have a kind of different value, more or less different. And that's important. And on the scope here, you see the voltage with which the circuit is driven. I couldn't find any peaks here. So I really don't know why all these transistors in the relay circuit burned out. Very, very strange. Anyway,